Hello friends, today I am here with another important topic of dynamics, that is work energy principle. It is one of the important topics because this principle is used to solve the many problems in engineering mechanics. Apart from work energy principle, you are having impulse momentum principle, then different types of energies, that is potential energy, which is energy possessed by virtue of its position, calculated using the formula P is equal to mgh. Again, kinetic energy, energy possessed by the motion, by virtue of its motion, that is calculated using formula half equal to m square. Before going for in detail all these particular points, so I just want to discuss about the work. What is work? So work is nothing but when particle undergoes a displacement along the line of action of force, then work done by the force is product of the force and displacement. Means work done is simply a product of force and displacement. Means to have the work or work done, there should be some sort of displacement, then and then we can say that work is done or force does the work. Its unit is Newton meter, means unit of force is Newton and unit of displacement is meter, or it is also can be called as a joule. Now I will discuss about the sign convention. It is denoted by another letter, that is U, capital U is used for a designation of this work done. So sign convention means when work done is positive, work done will be positive when displacement takes place in the direction of force. Means force and displacements are in the same direction, work done is considered as a positive. And when force and displacement are in opposite direction, it is said to be as a negative. After the application of force, if there is no displacement, then we can say that work done is zero or force does not have done any work. So you can see these figures. Block A, by applying force F, if it move to A dash, there will be some displacement, yes. And then we can say that work done will be equal to force and force into displacement. It is simply product of force and displacement. It's work done from 1 to 2 or A to A dash will be equal to F into dx. Now work done by inclined force. Suppose any force is acting inclined, then work done will be that inclined force has a two component. One is horizontal component at an angle theta, another is vertical component. That components will be F cos of theta and F sin of theta. So here only horizontal component can cause the displacement in a direction. So here work done by a horizontal component will be equal to F cos of theta into S. F cos of theta means what? This is the component of force, force into displacement. But work, as there is a no displacement in y direction, so work done by the vertical component will be 0 because there is a no displacement in y direction. Now next case is work done by the gravity force. As you know that when any object is moving in upward direction or downward direction, its motion is towards gravity or against the gravity. So here I have shown two blocks. Suppose when block is moving from S1 to S2 means it is moving against the gravity. Okay. So means here displacement is opposite to the direction of gravity. When it will move from S2 to S1, displacement will be towards the gravity. Means from S2 to S1 means displacement in the direction of gravity. So it will be considered as a positive, and opposite to the gravity will be considered as a negative. So simply work done can be calculated using formula. Work done is equal to W into H. W means weight, where W is equal to mg. So we can simply say that mg H, work done will be equal to mg H. This H will be positive or negative depending upon the direction of displacement. Next one, work done by the frictional force. Frictional force is always acting opposite to the direction of motion. Hence, work done by the frictional force is always negative, because that is acting always opposite to the direction of motion. We know that how frictional force is calculated. Frictional force F is equal to minus mu into N. Simply we are calculating F is equal to mu N. Here minus means negative because of opposite direction. So F is a frictional force, F is minus mu into N. The work done by frictional force will be equal to minus F into S, where minus F is nothing but the frictional force. I have just put that value here instead of F, minus mu into N into displacement. And sign convention will be always negative. Next one is the work done by the spring force. We know that springs are used for different purposes. So when spring is stretched or compressed, it does the work, means there will be displacement. But that displacement is opposed by the stiffness of the spring. So here you can see when displacement is from x1 to x2, so work done by the spring force, I have written it as a half into kx square. So work done by the spring force is calculated using this formula, half into kx square, where x is the displacement from x2 to x1. Okay, and then half into kx2 square minus x1 square. This formula will change like this, where k is the stiffness of the spring. It is also called as a spring constant, or it is also called as a modulus of spring. So what is spring stiffness of spring? It is nothing but the force required for unit displacement, where k is the force required for unit displacement. Means whenever we are going to stretch or compress the spring, so this k is very, very important. Stiffness is very important. The stiffness will try to oppose the deformation or compression. Hence, your work done by the spring is always negative when it is stretched or compressed, because whenever we are stretching, stiffness force is acting opposite direction. Whenever we are compressing, again that stiffness will try to oppose that compression, means your applied force and stiffness of the spring acts in opposite direction. That's why work done by the spring is negative when it is stretched or compressed. But when spring is, suppose initially it is stretched, but when it is returning to the original position, at that time work done by the spring will be positive, because already it was stretched, now it is returning to the original position, means what? That stiffness and deformation both are in the same direction. That's why work done of the spring will be positive. So while solving problem, you should keep this in mind, that when it is stretched or compressed, work done will be negative, but when it is returning to the original position, it will be positive. Now, before going to solve the problems, we must know work energy principle. As name itself indicates, that work energy principle means it must involve work done and energy. So in this particular work energy principle is derived from Newton's second law. As you know that Newton's second law is summation of F equal to ma, and we know that definition of acceleration. Acceleration is A is equal to rate of change of velocity, that is A is equal to dv by dt. I have just kept this A in this formula. Now it will be now like this, m into dv by dt. So here, to find out the relationship between force and displacement, we have to write this dv by dt term like this. Dv by dt will be equal to dv by ds into ds by dt. So here ds by dt is nothing but the rate of change of displacement, that is velocity. So instead of this ds by dt, I have just kept here v. You can see that formula is as it is. Summation of F equal to m into dv by ds means this term, and ds by dt means v. Now I have to make it general, so we should integrate it from this position 1 to 2. So displacement here, I have taken the summation of F here, ds I have taken to the left side, and this formula will be integral s1 to s2 into ds will be equal to m into initial velocity to final velocity u to v, and this term is v into dv as it is. Now integrate over it with S1 to S2 and U2 V, you will get for term summation of F into S2 minus S1 by putting this integration of ds is S and then putting limit, it will be S2 minus S1. And here M into integration of this V is V square by 2, it will be half into M square minus half into M U square by putting the limits. So what is the formula here? Summation of F into S2 minus S1 is what? Displacement. Summation of F into S will be equal to half into M square minus M square. Here is final velocity. Means final velocity minus initial velocity. So work energy principle is nothing but force into displacement will be equal to change in kinetic energy, that is final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. So to solve this particular problem, we need to modify the equation as per the problem's requirement. So in many cases the formula is stated like this: summation of F equal to S equal to half into M square. So F into S is nothing but work done. And change in kinetic energy means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. So this negative term can be taken to the left. So the equation will be in this particular form. Means while solving problem, you need to apply this particular equation. Now, we'll discuss about few problems based on work energy principle. Now you can see the problems. I have taken first problem. It is very simple problem. A woman having mass 70 kg stands on elevator which has downward acceleration 4 meter per second square starting from the rest. Determine the work done by her weight and work done by normal force which the floor exerts on her when elevator descends by 6 meter. So what is given here? You can see the mass of the woman is given 70 kg, stands on elevator, downward acceleration means elevator moving down, so that downward acceleration is mentioned, and it descends by 6 meter means it coming down by 6 meter, so the displacement is nothing but H, that is 6 meter. Now initially you have to calculate work done by her weight means what? Work done by weight is, work done by weight, we know the formula, it is mgh. As elevator moving down means motion is towards gravity, so this will be positive. So M is 70, G is 9.81, its displacement is 6 meters, work done by her weight is 4120.2 Nm or Joule. Now you have to calculate the work done by normal force. But before going for work done by normal force, we should calculate the magnitude of normal force. So for that purpose, you should use Newton's second law. Summation of Fy minus Mey. So here as lift is moving down, so W must be greater than N. Summation of Fy will be W minus N equal to M into Ey. So W is equal to Mg. So M is 70 into 9.81 minus N as it is will be equal to mass is 70 into acceleration in downward direction, that is 4. By putting all this value, you will get normal reaction. Then you are going to calculate work done by the normal force. Work done by the force will be equal to force into displacement. Here force is normal force and displacement is H, that is 6 meter. Now why this N is negative? Because motion is downward and N is acting upward. It is opposite to the direction of gravity. So that's why this will be negative, minus N into H. The normal reaction is minus 506.7 into 6 meter is the displacement. So you will get the work done by the normal force as 2440.2 Nm. Now see the problem number 2. Here it involves the spring. The spring is unstretched when x is 0. If the block moves from initial position x1, that is 100 mm, to final position x2, 200 mm, determine work done by the spring on the body and work done by weight. Take spring constant as a k equal to 4 kN/m. So initially spring is unstretched, means x is 0. Then it is stretched from 100 to 200. Means in meter it will be 0.1 meter to 0.2 meter. Means total displacement of the spring will be 100 to 200, means 100 mm, that is 0.1 meter. So x1 is 0.1 meter, x2 is 0.2 meter, k is 4 kN per meter. In Newton it will be 4000 Newton per meter. Initially we will calculate the work done by spring. Work done by the spring Here it is straight, it means it must be negative. Minus half into k into x2 square minus x1 square. I have just kept the values of k. K is 4000 newton meter, x2 is 0.2 and x1 is 0.1. So by solving this, you will get minus 60 newton meter as a work done by spring. Now you have to calculate work done by weight. To find out work done by weight, first of all, that block which is rested on inclined plane should be resolved into component, because due to this inclination 20 degree to the plane, this W will have two components in x direction, y direction. Here already we have seen that perpendicular component will not do any work because there is no displacement in y direction, but there is a displacement is in the x direction due to the this component, horizontal component of W. So here first of all you should know the magnitude of horizontal component. So total weight of the block is 7 kg. So 7 into 9.81 newton, that will be total W. It is resolved in x direction, 7 into 9.81 into sine 20. So why sine 20? Because this angle is 20 degree with vertical. So horizontal component will be sine 20. So magnitude of that particular force is 7 into 9.81 into sine 20, that is 23.48 newton. Now work done by weight on the body is nothing but the force into displacement. Force is 23.48 into displacement 0.2 to 0.1 or 0.1 to 0.2, that is 0.1 meter. By putting that value here, we will get the work done by the weight, that is 2.35 newton meter. Now I have taken another problem for understanding this work energy principle in better way. So here third example is car having mass 2000 kg is originally traveling with 2 meter per second. Determine the distance it must be traveled by force 4 kN in order to attain a speed of 5 meter per second. Here neglect the friction. It is asked in the problem that neglect the friction. On inclination of the plane, you should not apply any frictional force. Now write down given things first. Mass of the car 2000 kg. It will be converted into W. W is equal to mg, 2000 into 9.81. Now initial velocity is given, it travels with 2 meter per second, and determine the distance it must be traveled by force 4 kN in order to attain a speed of 5 meter per second. Means final velocity is also given, force 4 kN is given, that is acting here at 20 degree with horizontal, that is 4 kN means 4000 newton. Now they have asked to calculate the distance traveled when this force is applied and velocity change from 2 to 5. So we have to calculate S by using work energy principle. Now see, initially you must resolve that particular weight. Weight means what? This particular weight of the block, that is 2000 kg, which 2000, see here there are two forces, weight of the block 2000 kg, at the same time applied force is 4000 newton. So it must be resolved into component because that object is placed on inclined plane. So here first of all this force 4000 newton will have two component in x direction, 4000 cos 20, and in y direction 4000 sin 20. Now come to weight W. As m is 2000 kg. Now here there is a mistake, it must be m here instead of W. As mass is 2000 kg, so W will be 2000 into 9.81. So it will be resolved again with the inclination of 10 degree. So same angle will be maintained here, one vertical with vertical. So vertical component will be cos and horizontal will be sine. So here this 4000 newton will have two, this 2000 into 9.81 will have two component. 2000 into 9.81 into cos 10, it must be cos 10 because this angle is 10. Sorry for this mistake, it must be cos 10. Similarly here horizontal component will be 2000 into 9.81 into sin 10. This value must be sin 10. So mistakenly I have written it as a sin 20. It must be 10 with the plane. Now first of all you have to calculate the resultant force acting in horizontal plane. Resulting force means what? Rightward component is 4000 cos 20 minus leftward component is 2009.81 to sin 10. Here I have written that is sin 10. It is correct. So summation of F, net force acting in the system is 351.79 newton. Now using work energy principle, force into displacement will be equal to change in kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy minus final kinetic energy. Now put this net force 351 here, displacement you have to calculate, half into mass is given as 2000 into final velocity 5 square minus half into mu square, initial velocity 2 square. So by solving this you will get the total displacement as 59.69 meters. Now see this fourth problem. Again here I have taken very simple problem for better understanding. A package is projected 10 meter up. There is one package, means this block is nothing but package. It is projected 10 meter up on the inclined plane so that it reaches at the top with zero velocity. Determine the initial velocity of the package at A and take coefficient of friction 0.12. So here displacement is 10 meter, initial and final. You have to calculate so that it reaches at the top with zero velocity. Means final velocity is zero, initial velocity you have to calculate. Here mass is not given, so we will assume it as m only. So m is the mass, so w will be equal to mg. Now using one Kopargaon principle, you should resolve this package weight into x and y direction by drawing free body diagram. Here I assume that package means what? Its weight will be mg, that w will act vertically downward here, that will be called as mg. That mg will have two components, mg sin cos 15, mg sin of 15. Now it is moving up, it is moving up, projected up. So frictional force F will be equal to, frictional force will be equal to mu into n. So here mu k is given as 0.2, normal reaction will be n. So frictional force will be equal to 0.12 into this mg cos of 15. Mg cos of 15 means what? This particular component, this Fs is nothing but mu into n. So here normal reaction will be mg cos of 15. This normal reaction will be mg cos of 15. So here I have put mu k into n. Mu is 0.2, normal reaction is mg cos of 15. So you will get, here you will get normal reaction n is equal to mg cos 15, as well as frictional force Fs, mu k into n. Now resultant force, total resultant force acting in the system is nothing but this downward force minus plus this frictional force. Both are acting opposite to the direction of motion, so both will be negative because motion rightward, force is acting leftward. So minus 1 to mg cos of 15 means this is frictional force acting in downward direction. Fs means minus 0.12 mg cos of 15, and mg sin of 15, it is a component of W acting in left direction. So this will be total resultant force. Now using work energy principle, summation of F into S is equal to half mv square minus half mv square. So here I will put summation of F here, this rho value, it will be as it is into S as it is into change in kinetic energy by taking m here common, by taking m here common, this mm will cancel. By solving this we will get the only one unknown is there, that is u. You will get the value of u, that is the initial velocity of the block which it is projected up. So here g term is nothing but 9.81. Its value must be replaced as a 9.81. So in the, so friends, so here I have tried to explain the work energy principle in better way. For better understanding, you go through books, or you can also see the other videos available online. If you are having any queries, please contact me. Thank you. Thank you very much.